upgrade when I get there. Oh. Okay, hold on. Shepard, you take point. Yes, so now I can assign them. Now I can assign them, just give me a second. Give me a second, guys. I have to make sure. We'll cover the door. Make sure I don't miss anything. Okay. Going to cover. Oh, I see. So you don't hold down anything to tell them. You just press. I see. Oh, you started this. Oh, nice. Yeah, I forgot how good it is. It's freaking amazing. Wow, talk about overkill. Wow, really?
That mech's got heavy armor plating. Those Quarians never stood a chance.
This is gonna be one tough son of a bitch to take down.
Well, we gonna take him down on the same!
Overlord, we'll take out that sheep.
Here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna do this, and I'm gonna switch up to that. Okay, hold on. Hold on. We need to relocate, like, ASAP.
Moving to cover.
Oh, run! Run! Get in! Oh. Oh my god. Good job, guys! Oh, I see. He flew out here to give me a surprise. Oh, wow, look at that. He freaking crushed the hell out of him. Or her. Give me that iridium.
Now, what's this?
Ooh. Research data. Right, before we move on, let's scavenge this area here. Make sure we don't miss out anything. I keep forgetting. So that's the run. Okay, that's the run. Oh, Tally. Okay, we're not going to talk to Tally yet. Let's check this other place here. Calm down. Stop breathing heavy. Jeez. Oh. Oh, hang on, so does that, oh, yes! Yes! We're back on here. Okay, here we go again with this. This damn crazy thing. Oh god, this is gonna be... So you have to press it within a certain time frame, otherwise it doesn't work. Alright, so this room is clear. Let's check this other room here. Let's make sure we're not missing anything at all. And then we'll head up there to Tally. Oh man, seriously?
Monsters coming back. Mechs will protect. Safe from swarms. Have to hide. No monsters. No swarms. No, 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 no.
He's trying to protect himself.
Vitor?
No, Vitor. Not here. Swarms can't find. Monsters coming. Have to hide.
Nobody's gonna hurt you anymore.
I don't think he can hear you, Commander.
have to hide. Mechs will protect. Swarms coming. You're human. Where did you hide? How come they didn't find you?
Calm down, we killed them all.
Find us.
The monsters, the swarms, they took everyone.
God damn it. We weren't here.
We're not survivors, Vitor. We just got here.
You don't know. You didn't see. But I see everything.
Mm-hmm.
Looks like security footage. He must have pieced it together manually.
What the hell is that?
My God. I think it's a collector.
It's a collector! Mm-hmm. Thus recommence. Collectors. So this is the first time we're now hearing about the collectors. At the start of the game, we were told that human colonies were being attacked, but we didn't know if it was the Reapers or not. So now we know. It's the collectors.
That's some kind of alien?
They're a species from somewhere beyond the Omega 4 relay. Only a few people have ever seen one in person.
They usually work through intermediaries, like slavers or hired mercenaries. If they're involved with the Reapers somehow, it could explain what happened to the colonies.
The collectors have advanced technology. They could have a weapon that disables an entire settlement at once.
Wow. This is some heavy stuff.
Secret swarms. No one can hide. The Seekers find you, freeze you, then the monsters take you away.
Yeah.
Why didn't the collectors take you?
Swarms didn't find me. Monsters didn't know I was here.
The collectors aren't known for being careless. Maybe his enviro suit kept him from showing up on their sensors.
They were using technology specifically designed to detect humans. Only human colonies have been hit.
Tell me more about these swarms.
It's how they find you. Seeker clouds. Machines like tiny insects.
Ah.
They go everywhere. They find you. Then they sting you. Freeze you.
Sounds like miniature probes, maybe.
Mm-hmm.
Find victims, then immobilize them with a stasis field or nerve toxin.
Mm-hmm.
I want to know more about the collectors.
Nobody knows much. They're so rare, a lot of people don't even believe they exist.
More importantly, why are they abducting human colonists? What are they after?
Maybe the elusive man can figure it out.
Well, I guess it's time to...
What happened next?
The monsters took the people onto the ship, and then they left. The ship flew away. But they'll be back for me. No one escapes.
I think that's probably all we're getting out of him, Commander.
Yep. Thank you, Vitor.
We appreciate what you told us. You were very helpful.
I studied them. The monsters. The swarms. I recorded them with my Omni tool. Lots of readings. Electromagnetic. Dark energy.
We need to get this data to the elusive man. Grab the quarry and call the shuttle to come pick us up.
What? Vitor is injured. He needs treatment, not an interrogation.
We won't hurt him. We just need to see if he knows anything else. He'll be returned unharmed.
Your people tried to betray us once already. If we give him to you, we'll never get the intel we need.
Praza was an idiot, and he and his men paid for it. You're welcome to take Vitor's Omnitool data, but please... just let me take him.
You don't have to take Vitor and go. We could work together, just like old times.
I want to, but I can't. I've got a mission of my own. It's too important for me to abandon, even for you.
Oh.
When it's over, and I'm still alive, we'll see what happens.
That sounds dangerous. What are you doing?
I don't think Cerberus needs to hear about it. But it's in Geth space. That should tell you how important it is.
Vito goes with Tally, I'm afraid.
He's traumatized and he needs medical care. Tally will give us the Omnitool data and take him to the flotilla.
Understood, Commander.
Good job.
Thank you, Shepard. I'm glad you're still the one giving the orders.
Yeah! That's right, girl.
If I find anything that can help you, I'll let you know.
We're ready for pickup.
Collectors. The These guys are one creepy ass race.
Shepard, good work on Freedom's progress. The Quarians forwarded their findings from Vidor's debriefing. No new data, but it's a surprising olive branch given our history. You and I have different methods, but I can't argue with your results.
Well, listen to this.
You ever think about playing nice once in a while?
Mm-hmm.
Diplomacy is great when it works, but difficult when everyone already perceives you as a threat. But more importantly, you confirm the collectors are behind the abductions.
He doesn't seem surprised, does he?
Why do I get the feeling you knew about them already?
Mm-hmm.
I had my suspicions, but I needed proof. The collectors are enigmatic at best. They periodically travel to the terminus systems, looking to gather seemingly unimportant items or specimens, usually in exchange for their technology. When their transactions are complete, they disappear as quickly as they arrived, back beyond the unmapped Omega 4 relay. Until now, we've had no evidence of direct aggression by the collectors.
Okay, well, let's start.
Why is the Omega 4 relay unmapped? What do we know about it?
Only that no ship passing through it has ever returned. Our best guess is that the relay reacts differently to collector vessels, allowing them safe passage. If they can manipulate relays, that's just further evidence of the connection with the Reapers.
Mm-hmm.
Any ideas on why they've shifted their focus to humans?
If they're agents for the Reapers, it could be any number of reasons. Obviously, humanity played a huge role in Sovereign's destruction. That might have been enough to draw their attention. What really concerns me is why they bother abducting the colonists. Once the humans are paralyzed, why not just kill them?
Obviously, the Reapers have an interest in this, so, but we'll find out more.
What are the collectors getting from these deals?
The collectors aren't very forthcoming about their motives. Generally, they seek out species with rare genetic mutations or abnormalities. They pay slavers and merc groups exorbitant sums to obtain these specimens, and then they leave. But they've never targeted a single species before. And the previous sample sizes were in the dozens, not the tens of thousands.
You're holding something back. How do you know the Reapers are involved?
Mm-hmm.
The patterns are there, buried in the data. The Consul and the Alliance want to believe the Reaper threat died with Sovereign. You and I know better. I won't wait until the Reapers are on the march. We need to take the fight to them.
If this is a war, I'll need an army. Or a really good team.
I've already compiled a list of soldiers, scientists, and mercenaries. You'll get dossiers on the best of them. Finding them and convincing them to work with you could be challenging, but you're a natural leader. I'll continue to track the collectors. When they make their next appearance, I'll notify you and your team. Be ready.
I had a good team.
Keep your list. I want people I trust. The ones who helped me stop Saren and the Geth.
That was 2 years ago, Commander. Most of them have moved on, or their allegiances have changed.
Okay, well, let's go through it.
Where's Ashley Williams?
She's still with the Alliance. Promoted, I believe. Her file is surprisingly well classified.
Well, it was.
Where's Erdnut Rex?
He returned to Chichanka, and he hasn't gone off-world in over a year. He's trying to unite the Krogan clans.
Tally?
Tally. She already helped us with Freedom's progress.
That was unexpected. I need more intel before I'll commit to that.
All right, buddy, no worries. See you in a bit.
Where's Garrus Vakiri?
The Turian disappeared a few months after you were declared dead. Even we haven't been able to locate him.
Liara.
Where's Liara Tassoni?
She's on Ilium. My sources say that she's working for the Shadow Broker. If so, she can't be trusted.
Okay, I get it. They're not available.
You're a leader, Shepard. You'll get who you need.
I'm still a Spectre. Maybe I can get the Council to help us out.
If you think you could convince them, by all means. Just remember, you've been gone a long time. Things have changed.
You worry about the collectors. I'll make sure my team's ready.
Yeah!
Good. Two things before you go.
Oh, okay.
First, head to Omega and find Morden Solus. He's a brilliant Solarian scientist. Our intelligence suggests he may know how to counteract the Collector's paralyzing Seeker swarms.
I haven't even started and you're telling me what to do?
I'm giving you direction. What you do with it is up to you. I'm sure you'll make the right decision.
Alright. What's the other thing?
I've found a pilot I think you might like. I hear he's one of the best.
Yeah! You can trust. Oh, yeah! What's up, buddy?
Hey, Commander. Just like old times, huh?
Yeah!
Joker. I saw you get spaced.
Got lucky. With a lot of strings attached. How'd you get here?
It all fell apart without you, Commander. Everything you stirred up, the Council just wanted it gone. The team was broken up, record sealed, and I was grounded. The Alliance took away the one thing that mattered to me. Hell yeah, I joined Cerberus.
You really trust the elusive man?
Well, I don't trust anyone who makes more than I do. And there's this.
Oh. Screenshot time, guys. Screenshot time. Come on. Look at those sleek lines. She looks mighty fine. Come on, give us the full view. Yes!
I guess we'll have to give her a name.
Oh yeah! Looks good! Normandy. SR-2. I'm just going screenshot happy right now, guys. So freaking awesome. Okay. I also like the way they detailed, they now have mission reports. I like the way they've done it because it just summarizes each session. So I've got 19,000. Okay. Brand new Normandy, looking tasty. Rebuilt to spec, plus a few modifications. I love this tune. Loving this tune. I'm just taking screenshots.
Welcome aboard the new Normandy, Commander.
Oh yeah! It's my ship!
I've been looking over the dossiers. I'd strongly recommend starting by acquiring Morden Solus, the Solarian professor on Omega. We know the Collectors use some type of advanced technology to immobilize their victims. We'll need him to develop a countermeasure to protect us.
Good
Without
point.
That countermeasure, we'll be helpless if we ever run into the Collectors.
Acquiring Professor Solus seems like the most logical place to start.
Who are you?
Oh, Edie!
I am the
Edie!
Intelligence. The
I forgot about her.
Helmsmen aren't happy when someone takes control of a ship away from them. Especially Joker.
I do not helm the ship. Mr. Moreau's talents will not go to waste. During combat, I operate the electronic warfare and cyber warfare suites. Beyond that, I cannot interface with the ship's systems. I observe and offer analysis and advice. Nothing more.
Excellent.
I'm guessing it takes more than just the three of us plus Joker to fly this ship.
The Normandy has a full crew. They're at their stations awaiting your orders.
Final preparations for takeoff are complete, Commander. When you're ready to go, just pick a destination from the galaxy map and the CIC and I'll plot a course.
Jacob and I should return to our posts. Come find us if you have any questions.
Okay, so... So, yeah, so that works the same. Pick a new destination on the Normandy. Privateers read messages. Ah, Amri. Okay. Combat Information Center. Freaking awesome. Captain's Quarters. Ah, research upgrades for your squad's equipment. Yes, I think that will be the most logical step to take. Edie! First of all, first things first. Normandy.
Alliance space vehicle Normandy. With elaborate secrecy, Cerberus labored for years to build a new, superior Normandy. The vehicle's many alterations produced a craft nearly double the original size, requiring an even larger Tantalus drive core to compensate.
Okay.
The new Normandy,
let
the
me
Systems
see.
Alliance space vehicle Normandy is a.
This one looks amazing. It looks absolutely amazing. I don't think there's anything. Oh yeah, aliens, collectors. It's gonna be collectors.
Living beyond the Omega 4 mass relay in the Terminus systems, the mysterious collector species is glimpsed so rarely as to be taken for a myth by most in Galactica.
Right, journal. So we have a whole load of things to do. The convicts travel to purgatory. Archangel. Warlord. The Professor. Okay, so the Professor is what we're gonna do. Go to the Citadel. Stop the collectors. Okay, so first things first is we'll go to Aria at Afterlife. Okay, that's what we're gonna do first. Ah, two more points. Singularity. I think this will come. I think I need to. Well, I might actually hold on and try and do it bit by bit. Yeah, okay. Yes. Okay, let's save because we've just. This is our first time on here. Gosh. Oh, I remember. You can date her as well. My God.
I'm Yeoman Kelly Chambers.
Mm-hmm.
I've been assigned as your administrative assistant.
Mm-hmm.
I'll manage your messages and help you monitor the crew. And oh. I must say, it's such an honor to work under you, Commander Shepard.
I'm glad to have you on the team, Miss Chambers.
Please, call me Kelly.
Okay, Kelly.
Anything else?
Is there anything I should know?
You received a private message through Cerberus channels. I believe it's from Counselor Anderson. You can access it at your private terminal over there. Joker would like to speak to you on the bridge. Anything else, Commander?
Do you have a moment to talk?
I always have time for you, Commander.
What are your responsibilities?
I'll keep you notified of any messages or appointments you might have.
Very good, very good.
If the crew has important business to discuss, I'll make sure you know.
How do you feel about being assigned to the Normandy?
I was handpicked by the Elusive Man to help fight the greatest threat known to humanity. How do I feel? Honored, exhilarated, terrified. But mostly I feel encouraged. Under your leadership, we can't fail.
Having to, wrap myself up here because it is absolutely freezing. What do you think of Cerberus? Yeah.
This organization has a dark reputation. Do you have any concerns working for them?
Not at all. Our methods can be harsh, but Cerberus has noble objectives. We look out for human interests, advance human technology, save human lives. They're good goals.
It It sounds like Cerberus wants to dominate all aliens and put humankind on top.
Cerberus looks out for humanity, but that doesn't mean we hate aliens. My sister started a dog shelter, but she loved cats too. I love humanity. I also love Asari, Quarian, Turian, Salarian, Hanar. That isn't in conflict with Cerberus ideals.
Okay, well, you're very loving. You're naive.
That's a very positive attitude.
Yeah, good.
What can I say? I'm a people person.
Very
Anything
good.
Anything else you'd like to talk about?
Nope.
Better go.
Okay. Maybe we'll talk later.
Yeah, I'm gonna keep it all strictly professional with all these guys. And that way I get to get my Ashley in Mass Effect 3. I love this. They added some new terminals here as well. Oh, there are people here. Oh, yeah. Look at that. Actually, people on deck. Working their asses off. I just love all this. So, Joker wants to talk, and there's a message from Commander Anderson. Or Counselor Anderson. Okay, let's see. What do you want, Joker?
This Commander is my baby. Better than new. It fits me like a glove. And leather seats. Military may set the hardware standard, but on a first-gen frigate, they could care less if the seats breathe. Civilian sector comfort by design.
Reproduction is not intended to be perfect, Mr. Moreau. Seamless improvements were made.
And there's the downside. I liked the Normandy when she was beautiful and quiet. Now she's got this thing I don't want to talk about. It's like ship cancer.
Enjoy it, Joker. If we're stuck here, we might as well let them pamper us.
Damn straight.
Uniform regs if I get that on a crew shirt? Because this is my favorite. You have no choice. Choice ever.
Technically, this is a civilian ship. I'm probably lucky you're still wearing pants.
I'd say that for the off-hour cameras.
24/7. Hey, Edie. How are you doing, Edie?
I want to know more about you.
Do you have a specific inquiry?
Oh my god, so many... let's adjust my seat here for a second. There we go. You and Joker.
How are you getting along with Joker?
Mr. Moreau does not trust me. It offends him that I am installed aboard his ship's computers.
Yeah, the last Normandy did just fine without an AI reminding me the airlock is ajar.
Why are you named Edie?
Edie is the airlock is pronunciation ajar. Of EDI. That is an acronym for Enhanced Defense Intelligence.
Okay, location.
Where are you?
My core intelligence is housed in a quantum blue box located behind the medical bay.
Ah, okay.
What do you do aboard the ship?
I operate the ship's electronic and cyber warfare suites in combat. My reaction time is much faster than any organic. I collate the records of shipboard monitoring devices for the elusive man. I serve additional functions which are restricted at this time.
Okay, well.
Cyber warfare means things like viruses, right?
In close-range ship-to-ship combat, I can sometimes break through the firewalls of an enemy's internal wireless network. Once I seize control of their systems, I can turn off gravity or air. I can disable weapons guidance or shields, or I can put their fusion plant in meltdown. On the defense, I manage Normandy's own suite of jammers, decoys, and internal firewalls.
Okay, that's,
Sounds incredibly useful. Why isn't there someone like that on every warship?
An organic operator cannot react quickly enough to changing circumstances or perform the necessary multitasking.
Oh, Joker might not be happy.
Can only be filled by an artificial intelligence.
He might not be happy with that.
We are suspect.
Oh, I have something to do with how an AI almost destroyed galactic civilization. Just put it out there.
I knew he was going to say something like that. Alright, that's impressive. Let's see. Let's see, that's impressive. Let's see.
The elusive man has monitoring devices on board?
He has invested most of Cerberus's resources into the design and construction of this ship. He has an interest in monitoring our progress.
Well, that's fair enough, considering he spent all the money. Couldn't fault him there.
Restricted functions? Like what?
I do not know. Some of my databases are sealed, some of my hardware is kept offline. I assume that when certain unknown conditions are met, those functions will be released to me.
Okay, okay.
Let's discuss something else.
Ready.
I want to know more about the people I'm working with.
Much of that data is classified. Do you have a specific inquiry?
Okay.
What sort of resources does Cerberus have? Money, personnel, facilities?
Infinite.
I have a block that prevents me from answering that question.
What do you mean?
Although I am less controlled than other AI, I am still subject to behavioral blocks and the physical isolation of my hardware. In this case, I am prevented from truthfully answering your question by Cerberus's levels of secret classification.
How is Cerberus organized? Aside from the elusive man, I don't see much chain of command.
Cerberus is organized into task-oriented cells. Each operates in isolation. Members from one cell cannot recognize the members of another.
Which is very good, actually.
Single operator. We are called the Lazarus cell, which is directed by Operator Lawson.
There we go, that's better. Just adjusting my heating. There we go, that's much better. Okay. How many cells are there?
How many operations is Cerberus running right now?
I have a block that prevents me from answering that.
Another block. building the Normandy.
Did Cerberus replicate the most advanced warship in the Alliance Navy without anyone knowing?
I have a block that prevents me from answering that question.
Let's discuss something else.
This room.
What's this area of the ship?
This is the bridge, where the navigator plots our FTL vectors, and the helmsman maneuvers the ship.
Yeah, sitting right here, thanks.
That's all for now.
Logging you out, Shepard.
Wow, Edie's so cool. I like Edie. Right, so we have a message from Counselor Anderson. Okay, so we have all these available. The Warlord. Ah, this is obviously Rex. Archangel. The Convict. Jack. Oh yeah, that girl. Upgrades. Oh, we can't do anything at the moment. See, archive messages. Just make sure there's nothing. Oh, no, we don't need to watch that. Unread messages. Anderson. Okay. All right. So obviously they found out that I'm working with Cerberus, and I guess they're not very happy about it. So, well, it's fair. We'll go to the council just after we've
economic pact for collective colonial security. The Alliance is the central galactic institution of human society. The Alliance gained associate membership to the Citadel Council in 2165 and full membership in 2183, with Ambassador David Anderson representing humanity.
Okay. Oh, there's something else on the codex. Ah, technology. What are we looking for? Ah, okay, that's what we... yeah. That's fine. Ah, let's save there. Well, I guess there is... well, let's check out the ship first of all. I mean, it's only fair, right? So... weapon loadout, Shepard. Yeah, we haven't got any options at the moment. Shotgun. Okay, yeah, I think we make modifications to the weapons. Yes, if I remember. And this is Jack. Yeah, I think we make modifications. But, I mean, I can still see the assault rifle. Sniper, yep. Some more snipers, yeah. Okay, okay, okay. Ooh. Wow, look at that thing vibrating. Jeez. Okay, let's see if Jacob has anything to say.
Commander, there hasn't been time to really settle in and take stock.
Damn straight.
Working with you is a great opportunity to do something that matters.
Yes, sir.
To serve on the Normandy, Commander.
You may change your tune if we end up like the original Normandy.
Maybe. As long as the elusive man walks his talk, and you do the same, I'll do my best to make sure we succeed.
Good job, buddy.
Condition for my service so far. I have issues with certain actions Cerberus has taken in the past.
What has Cerberus done to make you nervous?
A lot. They've been called terrorists, and with good reason. Doubt you can find a more checkered past. But if the Collector threat is real, and we do something about it, Cerberus will be remembered differently. Or we'll all be tried and executed. Can't count on people thinking about it as hard as I have.
I look forward to working with you, Mr. Taylor.
Likewise, Commander. Let me know if you need anything.
Good job. Right, so that's him. So let's kind of navigate our way through and see what's what. So this is the comms room. Yeah, I remember this. Yeah, Edie's there. I think she tells us this is the comms room.
A scientist is required to use the technical lab.
Uh-huh, yes, yes. Yes, that's Edie. Alright, so let's see what's... Oh, that's the lab. Thanks. So... Hang on. Crew quarters. We're on combat information. Let's go to my stuff from the top. On this floor is just mine, so that's good. That's CD.
What's this area of the ship?
This is the commanding officer's quarters.
It's larger than the quarters of other warships I've served on.
This is a Cerberus vessel, not an Alliance warship. Accommodations have been made for personal taste. That said, this space is directly under the exterior pressure hull. The fitting yard workers called it the loft.
Very nice. And here we can also check messages. Return to active duty. Save your crew from an overwhelming attack. Okay, okay. What was that? 15 new, okay, okay. Yeah, so these are our upgrades. Alrighty. Check our weapons there, we can change there. Yeah. It's good. It's very good, very good. I'm loving this. I get music. My own room and some music. Loving that. Right, we came from here, so let's go here. Let's check out what this is. Crew quarters. Ooh. I'll start from the back.
Access to life support is restricted.
So this is a what is this? Women's restroom. Okay, it was pretty restroomy.
Oh, she's a cutie. How old?
She'll be a year old next month.
Oh, you'll miss her first birthday.
Family lives in New Canton.
Oh, that colony's on the edge of the frontier. could be vulnerable to collector attack, couldn't it?
Exactly. It's most important that she have a first birthday. That's why I'm here.
Oh, very, very good. Very good, buddy. Very good. So very organized. Very nice. I'm really liking it here. Okay, so we've seen here. Let's go around here. I think Dr. Chakwas is still here.
Chef surprise again. Come on, Rupert.
I'm sorry, princess. Filet mignon and caviar coming right up. Just get out my doilies. Commander Shepard, the hero of the Citadel. You did humanity proud that day. I'm Sergeant Rupert Gardner here. How can I be of service?
You have everything you need.
I make do, but have you ever tried to prepare a decent meal with military provisions? I'm good, but I'm no miracle worker. Taking down the collectors is going to be rough business. The crew deserves a few fine meals before they throw themselves into the fire.
Okay.
What do you need?
If I had some quality ingredients... Oh, shit. You've got more to worry about than grocery shopping on the Citadel. Forget I mentioned it.
Give me the list.
If I head that way, I'll keep an eye out.
Much appreciated. Most of this list is probably standard fare for those namby-pambies on the Citadel. Anything else you'd like to talk about?
What do you do here on the Normandy?
What don't I do? Most think of me as the ship's cook, but I'm also the facilities technician and custodian. HVAC, plumbing, non-mission critical electrical. I make sure they're all clean and running.
Nice.
So the man cleaning the toilets is also preparing the meals.
I wash my hands most of the time. This is no luxury liner. You have to pull your own weight out of the vessel, and I catch what falls through the cracks. Through the cracks.
Yeah, I got that as well.
How do you feel about working for Cerberus?
Damn proud. Cerberus gets